Hello, my name is Stephen, and in this video I'm going to take you through the ray tracing spray coating method in Altair eDerm. Coating is common in many different industries. Pharmaceutical tablets, food processing and agriculture are the three main areas. And eDerm can also be used in the different stages of tablet manufacturing, including mixing, analysis of the forces and the damage, and the compaction process, as well as the tablet coating process. There are many different shapes of particles available in eDerm: spherical cylinders, multi-sphere particles, shown as point one here, and polyhedral particles. For the ray tracing tablet coating method, we're looking at the polyhedral particle analysis today. The ray tracing tablet coating method gives us a distribution of coating across one tablet, the intraparticle spray coating method. This is a post-processing method only, and that allows you to simulate different configurations without re-simulating. It allows you to do the analysis without re-simulating. And it can also be used for inter-tablet coating as well as intra-tablet coating. So it allows you to look at the distribution of coating across all the tablets in the simulation, as well as the distribution of coating across the surface of one tablet. There are other types of coating methodologies and analysis that you can do in eDerm. There's the spray coating method, which is an inter-particle spray coating method. This gives you one value per tablet. It's a contact model, which means that the simulation has to be rerun if you change the spray location. The small spray particles transfer mass to the tablets, but the data saved doesn't influence the results, and it can be used for any particle type. We also have the residence time method. This, strictly speaking, isn't a tablet coating methodology. However, it allows you to do the analysis of the tablet residence time in the specific spray zone, predefined zone, and this also calculates at runtime. This simulation has already been set up and run. With the ray tracing coating method, this has the advantage that we can run all the post-processing after the simulation has completed. This means that we can run one simulation and then do the analysis of the different spray zones and different spray areas without having to rerun our simulation. We just change the spray locations and redo the analysis. This is a generic tablet coater equipment. It's been filled with a tablet material, which in this case is the different types of polyhedral particles. The body of the equipment has a rotation assigned to it in order to mix and rotate the material for the coating. If I move to the simulator, we can see the simulation has been run for 50 seconds already, and we have saved the data at this target save interval. This frequency is important for the ray tracing method, as these are the data points that we have to work with. If we set up our simulation with the other methods that I mentioned at the start of the video, we can do the analysis every simulation time step, the fixed time step. But for the ray tracing method, the analysis is only applied each target save interval. Going to the analyst, we can play through our video and see the coater in operation. Initially starts from stationary and we rotate and create a nice flow profile. We have our spray bar already set up with the CAD ready to do the analysis of the spray coating. I'll let this play through and we want to go to the last time step and look at our predefined views. To set up the spray coating analysis, This is the ray tracing method, so it's purely done post-processing. First off, we define a position for our rays, which are going to be cones, and we'll assign them to this spray bar. EDEM then interprets the rays and the density of the rays and assigns a property to the particles that they hit, and we do this with adding a spray coating item. We don't want it to start at time of zero when the material is stationary. We'll start this at 3 seconds. Set a material spray density of 1,000 kilograms per meters cubed, which is reasonable, and set a density coefficient of 0.8. The density coefficient is a dimensionless number that controls the number of rays that the ray tracing method is using. A higher number would be a slower method, but it provides more detailed analysis. And a value of 0.8 or 1 is approximately 1 ray per particle face for a particle which would be the furthest from the spray. There's further information about this method in the EDEM help. Next, we want to right-click, add spray nozzle, and add this to the position that we want. Let's assign some information to it. So mass flow rate of 1 kilogram per second, an angle of 68 degrees, and a length of 120 millimeters. We want to set the position rather than have it facing upwards, so I know the spray zone is 2.7 millimeters along in the X, 51 millimeters in Y, and 5.3 in Z to place it in the starting position. At the moment, the ray is facing upwards, so let's rotate it so it's directed towards the material bed, 140 degrees. And this is one spray zone created. We want to create the remaining three to cover the remaining bed. So let's add spray nozzle, right-click, and again to add the four different nozzles. 1 kilogram for all of them, 68 degrees. Let's add this for all the sprays. And the length also is going to be the same for each one, 120 millimeters. Let's also set the X, Y, and Z positions, copy and paste these into the different zones. So we'll all end up with having these at the same starting position initially. And rotate them all to 140 degrees so they're all facing in the correct axis. Now we want to move them all along in the Y direction. First one being 51 millimeters. So let's place the second 100 millimeters further along, 151. The third one, 251. And spray nozzle four, this will be 351 millimeters. Now we've set up all of our spray areas. The final step is to do the analysis of the spray coating. So right click on the model and do analyze spray coating. And we can see this brings up a warning, which we'll choose OK. This brings up the Python post-processing method for the spray coating. So I'll let this run, and when we can follow up and do the analysis of the results. Okay, so I paused and rerun the video, and the script now is complete. And it's written the coating information to the particles. What I'll also show is that we have a series of HTML pages where we can see the simulation results. These HTML files are in the same folder as the simulation.dem file. And you can see here we have the mass and the thickness specified in the file names. These can be opened in a web browser, and we can see here the tablet, and what it's displaying is an average coating that's across all the particles in the simulation, and this is displayed on a representative polyhedral particle. We can interact with this and move around to look at the distribution, and we have a good coatage coverage on the top, but maybe not so good around the edges, relatively speaking, to the top face. This is the coating for mass. We also have the coating for the thickness as well shown. So I'll go back to the analyst, and if we go to our particles, we want to then display the coating on the particles as well. There's some new parameters written to the model, the coating mass and the coating thickness. Choose auto update for minimum and maximum values, and we can see the different spray areas, the influence of them, and the thickness, the mass of the coating in these areas. If I also display the thickness, we can see a very similar distribution here as well. And that's the analysis of our spray coating. We can do further investigation into this. We can see from the video, the analysis, or through the data export, we'd be able to do some further number crunching. And it's clear that after 50 seconds, visually, we can see that not all the tablets are coated evenly. We can run for longer, we can look at changing our spray zones, changing our kinematics as well. So thank you for listening. I hope this video on ray tracing tablet coating in EDEM